Hey everybody, Armand here, Qi Skills, and today we're looking at how to open the shoulders in Tai Chi and Qigong. There seems to be a little bit of confusion about that, so let's begin. Okay, so the shoulder seems to be hard to open for people, right? I see a lot of loose arm movement in Tai Chi and Qigong, and that's not strange because that's what we're used to, right? That's how we live our lives, right? So, but for Tai Chi, we're looking for something different. We're looking for the energy body. We're looking for fascia and tendons and elasticity of the muscles, right? So in order to connect the arm with the body in that way, because obviously it's already connected, but in a stretch way, we have to approach it differently. Okay, so do this with me, right? I imagine between my fists, an elastic wire, right? Pretty thick. There's a resistance there. So what I'm doing now on an in-breath, I start gently pulling on this wire, right? So what's happening now is that the elbows move away from the shoulders, and that's when the shoulder opens, right? Well, this direction, this pulling, we call yin, right? Yin, 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 yin. Okay. In order to go yang, I open hands and imagine a spring between my hands. Pretty tough, the spring, right? And now I start pushing into the spring. And now I can feel, again, opening of the shoulder, but in another direction, right? This is pushing, yang. So I go back to the elastic wire, yin, and start pulling. And then I change to the spring and I start pushing. So if you're doing this with me, you can now feel that all the tendons here are activated around the shoulder. And that's exactly what we're looking for, right? That's the elasticity kicking in. So from this point, we want to make it a bit more subtle, right? So again, I grab this wire, but now it's light, right? But there is still resistance, a little bit. So on an in-breath, I gently pull. And now I'm doing exactly the same thing. Again, I'm pulling and the elbows move away from the shoulders, right? Now I move to the spring again, but the spring is much lighter, but there's still a spring, right? So I start gently pushing into the spring and I'm still opening the shoulders, right? So yin and yang. Now we can leave the hands open, which is more the Tai Chi approach, and imagine the elasticity between the fingertips, right? And I open, gently bring the elbows away from the shoulders, and then start pushing into the spring, right? From there, I can do the same thing, push out to the front. Same thing, I'm lengthening here. I'm stretching the elbow away from the shoulder, right? And now I change direction and imagine wires from a point there, and now I start pulling on the elasticity. And now I'm still pulling the shoulder open, right? Pulling and pushing. Pulling and pushing. So the danger here might be that you're hinging too much in the shoulder, right? And this is loose. No, what we want is not up and down. We want to stretch the elbow away from the shoulder, right? Away. And then pushing, it still goes away. Pulling, it goes away. Pushing, it goes away. Well, I hope this helps. Of course, this has to be implemented in your Tai Chi form or in your Qigong exercises. Make sure that you build a lot of pressure in the beginning. Push into the spring and pull on this wire, right? Make sure that you put some elasticity in that, right? I wanted to say muscle, but use the elastic part of the muscle, right? So put some tendons in there, right? That's the word I was looking for. Tendons. And from there, just make it lighter and lighter and lighter, and then you're in business. Okay? So if you like this one, like and subscribe. If you've already done so, thank you very much. And thanks for the wonderful comments. We'll sure be making more. And well, goodbye from Holland. Like and subscribe. Bye-bye.